In this video, I will integrate tangent square x dx. First of all, integrating tangent square x dx is the same as integrating sine square x over cosine square x dx. That's also the same as integrating sine square x times 1 over cosine square x dx. And this is secant square x. I can write this as integrating sine square x secant square x dx. Now, this is a product of two functions here. So I will use the integration by parts to integrate this. We call it integration by part formula. Integral of u dv is equal to uv minus integral v du. Now over here, which function am I gonna set as u, which function am I gonna set as dv? I probably will let this one equal to u because the derivative of sine square x is not that hard. And I will let this one equal to dv because the integral of secant square x dx is just tangent x. So let me do this. U equals to sine square x. So let me write this, label this. This is u, this is dv. So what is du? So let's figure out what du is. So u is equal to sine square x, same as sine x times sine x. What is du dx? To find, this is the product of two functions. To find the derivative, we need to use the product rule. The derivative of sine x is cosine of x times sine x plus sine x times derivative of sine x is cosine of x. So du over dx is 2 sine x cosine of x. Multiply both sides by dx to get du. So I have du equals to 2 sine x cosine of x dx. Now I have my du, I'm going to write here. 2 sine x cosine of x dx. Like I said before, I let dv equals to this secant square x dx. What is v? V is the antiderivative of a secant square x dx, which is tangent x. Okay, now I have these four elements. I can use this formula now to find the integration. So integrating u dv, basically integrating this, the same as integrating tangent square x dx. So well, let's make some distinction here. I can write that integrating tangent square x dx is equal to, I'm gonna write here, uv. So u is u times v, so sine square x times tangent x, basically sine square x times tangent x minus integral of v du. So v times du, tangent x times 2 sine x cosine of x dx. Now we know that this identity, tangent x is equal to sine x over cosine of x. So I can replace tangent of x with this to simplify this a little bit. So this is sine square x tangent x minus integral sine x over cosine of x times 2 sine x cosine of x dx. As you can see here, the cosine x will cancel out with each other. The sine x and sine x multiply become sine square x, and I can take out a constant too. So when we write this, sine square x tangent x minus 2 integral, I'm take out the 2. Now this is sine square x dx. As you can see, this part is pretty good. You don't have to do much. We just need to figure out the integral of sine square x dx. Now what is the integral of sine square x dx? We know that we have a reduction formula to find the integral of sine to the power of nx dx, and which is negative 1 over n times cosine x times sine to the power of n minus 1 x plus n minus 1 over n integral sine to the power of n minus 2 x dx. And in this case, we know that n is equal to 2. So let's replace n with 2 in this formula. So let's begin. Integral of sine squared x dx equals to negative 1 over 2 cosine of x sine to the power of 2 minus 1 x plus 2 minus 1 over 2 integral sine 2 minus 2 x dx. Let's simplify this. Integral of sine squared x dx is equal to negative 1 over 2 cosine of x. 2 minus 1 is 1. This is sine x plus this is 1 over 2 integral 2 minus 2 is 0. Sine x to the power of 0 is 1. 1 times dx is dx. Now, this part here is pretty much good. We just need to find out the integral of dx. The integral of dx is just x. So we know that integral of sine squared x dx is equal to negative 1 over 2 cosine x sine x plus 1 over 2 x. But I would always like to put the positive in the front, negative in the back, so I'm going to rewrite this. I will put this in the front, 1 half x minus 1 half cosine of x sine x. That's it. But since there's a common factor 1 half, I will factor out a 1 half. 1 half times x minus cosine of x sine x. Okay, so now this is the integral of sine squared x dx, which I can plug into here. I can plug this into here to finish this. So this is same as sine squared x tangent x minus 2 times 1 half times x minus cosine of x sine x. Well, we can see that 2 times 1 half is just 1. So basically what I have is equal to sine squared x tangent x. Now minus x plus minus minus plus plus cosine of x sine x. So let me just switch these two terms. That's the same as sine squared x tangent x plus sine x cosine of x. Well, cosine of x times sine x is the same as sine x times cosine of x. So that was x here, cosine of x times sine x minus x. Okay, so over here we can still simplify a little bit. So going back to this identity, sine x over cosine of x equals the tangent x. We see that this is sine squared x. If we can get a cosine squared x, then maybe we can pull it out. So over here, sine x is actually equal to tangent x cosine x. So basically, multiply both sides by cosine of x. So this is sine x, tangent x times cosine of x. So I can replace sine x with tangent x cosine of x here. So this is sine squared x tangent x plus tangent x cosine x times cosine of x minus x. This is cosine squared x. Basically, it's equal to sine squared x tangent x plus tangent x times cosine squared x minus x. Well, since both factor here has both term has the common factor tangent x, let's take out tangent x. So this is equal to tangent x times sine squared x plus cosine squared x minus x. Recognizing this this identity, this is just equal to 1. So we know that this is equal to tangent x times 1 minus x. This is equal to tangent x minus x. That's the final integral for tangent squared x dx. Since we are done, we will add the constant c, because there might be a constant there. So here's the final answer. The integral for tangent square x dx is tangent x minus x plus c. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.